Hey everyone, I'm here to teach you MSC, a board game for 2 to 4 player, designed by We Radio Loan and published by various NGOs starting from United in Diversity in 2016, WWF Indonesia in 2017, and Yayasan Indonesia Cerah in 2023. MSC is also available as free PNP, print and play, with files you can access at this link. MSC is a board game designed to teach or talk about climate change, sustainable development, as well as the global climate negotiation and frameworks. The main goal of the game is to get people discussing and engaging with wicked problems with the hope that it may help introduce or even untangle some of the concepts that may sometimes feel insurmountable. Hopefully, everything in the folder has been prepared so that it's easy enough for you to print, play, and have fun with, even if you just have access to a regular paper printer. For further discussions, etc., please feel free to contact the creator on Instagram or Twitter with the handle MahawiraSD. Welcome to MSC! In this game, everyone is trying to cut down their carbon dioxide emissions. Yes, CO2 is the big bad here. But there is a twist! Each of you plays as a world leader, with your own goals, agendas, and maybe even a few sneaky ambitions. So even though you may be working together with the other players to save the planet, at the same time, everyone is also trying to come out on top. This tension is what makes MSC such a delicate dance of strategy and compromise with the dash of raucous rivalry thrown in for a good measure. Objective of the game. There are two ways MSC can end. 1. If the Earth becomes overwhelmed, meaning all 40 MSC slots are filled, the game ends immediately and everyone loses. But if you survive through 6 full rounds and the Earth still has room to breathe, that is, it hasn't hit the MSC limit, then player counts points and one of you wins. So yes, you'll need to cooperate, but only one of you can come out on top. Setup. Place all the MSC tokens into the MSC bag, randomly draw 20 tokens, and place them on the Earth board. There are 40 slots, but only 20 get filled at the start. Just spread them randomly. From the resource deck, find all the graded forest cards. Give 2 to each player and place them face up in front of them. Shuffle the remaining resource cards, including remaining degraded forests, and deal 5 to each player. This is your starting hand. Shuffle and deal 5 solution cards to each player, add them to your hand. Shuffle the secret objective cards and deal 2 cards to each player, return the rest to the box without looking at them. Shuffle the event cards and place them face down on the corresponding space. Place the research and solution decks next to the game board and save some space for the discard pile next to them. Each player draws 3 random coins from the money bag and place them face down on their play area. Generally, your hands, coins, and your secret objectives are secret from the other player. Place the action marker near the action track and the round marker on the number 1 space on the round track. Now pick your difficulty level. The harder it is, the more MSC tokens you add now. Use the chart on screen to decide. Finally, choose the first player. It's whoever walked or commuted the furthest today. Give them the first player marker. General ideas. A few important things before we dive into gameplay. Coins come in 1, 2, and 3 denominations, but they are secret. When you gain coins from the global bank, draw randomly from the money bag. When paying, you must use the exact coin values you have. No change is given. When the game instructs you to put MSC token to the atmosphere, draw the indicated number randomly from the bag and place them face down on the board. But keep their value secret. But you can inspect it before you put it on the board. Whenever the game instructs you to get MSC token, get any number the game instructs you to from the board. There is no maximum hand size in this game. You may hold as many cards as you want. Phases of play. Each round in MSC has 2 phases, the action phase and the upkeep phase. Starting with the first player, each player takes their action phase in turn. Once all players have finished their actions, the game proceeds to the upkeep phase, followed by the next round. Action phase. At the start of each action phase, the active player first refreshes all rotated cards in their play area, turn them upright to show they are ready to be used again. Then draw the top even card, resolve its effect, and place it in the even discard pile. After that, the player may perform up to 5 actions, choosing freely from the 5 available options. Business as usual, survey, research, initiate, activate. Action can be taken in any order, and the same action can be repeated multiple times. BAU, business as usual. Take 2 coins from the money bag and draw 2 MEC tokens from the MEC bag. Secretly look at them, then place them face down on any empty slot on the game board. Survey. Draw 2 cards from the resource deck, choose 1 to keep, and discard the other into the resource discard pile. Research. Works just like survey, but using the solution deck instead. Draw 2 cards, keep 1, and discard the other to the solution discard pile. Initiate. Play a card from your hand. Depending on the type of the card, do the following. If the card shows a rotate or discard icon, place it into your play area, paying the cost listed on the card, if any. Most costs are paid with the money value of coins, while some are paid by discarding cards already in play which have forest in their name and display the forest icon in the upper right corner. If the card has a direct icon, pay the cost and resolve the effect immediately, then discard it to the appropriate discard pile. Activate. Choose a card in your play area to activate its effects. Let's look at each card again in detail. There are 3 keywords to keep your attention to when you initiate and activate. Discard. The card enters your play area and remains there until you activate it. Rotate. Place the card in your play area, then when you activate it, rotate the card to indicate it is already activated this turn. Direct. These are one-time effects. You initiate the card, resolve its action right away, then discard it. After you perform an action, move the action marker to the next space to indicate the action is complete. After you have taken 5 actions, your turn ends, and the next player in clockwise order takes their turn. Here is an example of one turn. At the start of my turn, I refresh all rested cards in my play area. Then I draw 1 even card, read it out loud, and resolve its effects. The volcanic eruption events make me place 3 MEC tokens into the atmosphere. I then place the even card face up in the even discard pile. First action. I take the survey actions, I draw 2 cards from the resource deck, add conservation forest to my hand, and discard the other. I move the action marker to the next space. Second action. I initiate the conservation forest project. I place the card in my play area by paying its cost, 1 money and 1 forest. I return 1 coin to the money bag and discard a degraded forest to pay for the forest icon cost. I move the action marker to the next space. Third action. I activate conservation forest by rotating it sideways. I pay 1 coin, returning it to the money bag, and remove 3 MEC tokens from the atmosphere, which I then place in my play area. I move the action marker to the next space. Fourth action. I take the business as usual action. I gain 2 coins from the global bank and place 2 MEC tokens from the bag into the atmosphere. I move the action marker to the next space. Fifth action. For my last action, I initiate the accelerated research card. I pay 5 money to draw 5 cards from the solution deck, and then I discard 2 of them.
my country is now ready to develop more advanced technology in the next round. This completes my fifth action. My turn ends and I return the action marker to the first space. Every player then rotates all cards in their play area to its upright position if any of them are rotated sideways. Play continues with the next player in clockwise order.
Upkeep phase.
After all players have taken their turns, proceed to the upkeep.
Pass the first player token to the left. Add MEC token to the board based on the chosen difficulty level. Check the total MEC on the board. If there are more than 40 tokens, the game ends immediately and all players lose. Otherwise, proceed to the next round. If this is the end of round 6, move on to the scoring phase. Flip all remaining MEC tokens on the board and sum their values.
If the total is more than 1000 gigatons, the game ends with no winners due to cataclysmic climate change.
If the total is between 425 and 1000 gigatons, you will score using the high emission scenario.
Tally your victory point based on this multiplier. 2 VP for every 25 gigatons of emissions sequestered in your play area. 1 VP for every solution card in your play area and your hand. 3 VP for every resource card in your play area and your hand. 20 VP if you complete either or both secret objectives. 1 VP for every point of money you have in your play area. Here is a scoring example. The game ends with MEC tokens on the board worth 600 gigatons. This means that the game ends with a high emission scenario. During the game, you have sequestered 150 gigatons of emissions and they now net you 12 VP. You have one solution card in play and two in hand. They are worth a total of 3 VP. Meanwhile, you have also 5 resource cards in play and 2 in hand, which are worth a total of 21 VP. Furthermore, you completed both secret objectives. However, you still only gain 20 VP for completing your secret objectives. Finally, you have 10 money, which is worth 10 VP. Therefore, your final score is 66 VP.
If the total is between 0 and 400 gigatons, you will score using the low emission scenario.
Tally your victory point based on this multiplier. 1 VP for every 25 gigatons of emission sequestered in your play area. 2 VP for every solution card in your play area and your hand. 4 VP for every resource card in your play area and your hand. 20 VP if you complete either or both secret objectives. 1 VP for every point of money you have in your play area. Here is the scoring example. The game ends with MEC tokens on the board worth 200 gigatons, signifying a low emission scenario. During the game, you sequestered 225 gigatons of emission worth a total 9 VP. You also have 2 solution cards in play and 2 in hand, which are worth a total of 8 VP. Subsequently, you have 4 resource cards in play and 2 in hand, so they are worth 24 VP. Furthermore, you completed one of your secret objectives, so you score 20 VP. Finally, you have 10 money left at the end of the game, so they score you 10 VP. Therefore, your final score is 71 VP. After everyone has completed their final scoring, the player with the most points wins. If there is a tie, the tied player with the highest total emission sequestered wins. If there is still a tie, the tied player with the most cards in their player area wins. If there is still a tie, the tied player with the most coins wins. And if there is still a tie, all tied players share their victory. And that concludes the tutorial for MEC. We hope this video helps you understand the world of the board game MEC a bit better. For more details, please refer to the rulebook included in this game. Thank you for watching. May your choices in MEC lead to a greener, more sustainable world on the table and beyond.